Welcome to an overview of how to manage MSDN subscriptions purchased through Microsoft Volume Licensing. Software, services, support, and training. MSDN subscriptions provide a comprehensive and cost-effective set of resources. These resources help your development team succeed at building apps for the web, desktop, cloud, server, and phone. MSDN subscriptions provides access to a huge software library, including past, present, and future software. Your team can improve agility and team collaboration with Microsoft's Application Lifecycle Management solution and develop and test applications faster with Windows Azure. With a simple per-user licensing model, your team will have everything it needs to be successful on Microsoft platforms. To learn more about MSDN subscriptions benefits, check out the MSDN subscriptions website. As an MSDN administrator, you play an important role in helping your company gain maximum value from these subscriptions. As a primary steward of the MSDN administration plan, you also play an important role in your company's licensing compliance. Be prepared to participate in and provide data inputs for annual true-ups, monthly assignment changes, and audit engagements. Your key responsibilities are to understand the benefits and limitations of MSDN subscriptions to help your company manage costs. Assign MSDN subscriptions to specific, named individuals in accordance with your company's volume licensing contract. Inventory your pre-production environment to ensure that you license users correctly. Track user assignment changes and acquire additional licenses on schedule. We encourage you to learn more about these responsibilities by reading the MSDN Subscription Administrator's Guide. This video shows how an MSDN administrator can add and remove subscribers and modify subscriber information. It also shows how to view shipping and subscription summary information. To get started, click the Sign In button on the VLSC site. Type your Microsoft account and password. From the VLSC homepage, there are two ways to access the MSDN subscription administration area of the site. When you click Subscriptions in the top navigation menu, two choices appear on the submenu, MSDN Search and Subscriptions. Although either choice will lead you to the subscriptions management area, the MSDN Search option is the quickest path to use. In this video, we will demonstrate the use of the MSDN Search option. Click MSDN Search. To manage an MSDN subscription, you must first find its corresponding agreement. On the MSDN Subscription Administration page, you can search for agreements by using Agreement Information or Subscriber Information. After you provide the required information in one or more of the fields on the page, click Search. The agreement information will display in the agreement area of the MSDN Subscription Administration tool. When you search for agreements, the tool will display up to a maximum of 5,000 agreements in the search results. When the list of results from your search appears, to view the detailed subscriber information for the agreement, click an agreement number or a public customer number. From this page, you can assign subscriptions to a single subscriber or to multiple subscribers simultaneously. Track shipments. View a summary of subscriptions you've purchased and assigned. Remove a subscriber or resend an invitation to activate a subscription. Please view the other sections of this video for more details about managing MSDN subscriptions. One of your key responsibilities as an administrator is to assign MSDN subscriptions to specific named individuals per the requirement outlined in your volume licensing contract. When you want to assign a subscription, click the Assign Subscription tab. Next, select the subscription level for the subscriber. The subscription level should correspond to the license you purchased. Subscriptions are licensed per user. You must assign all the component benefits of the subscription to the same person. The benefits cannot be shared with others. Microsoft recommends that you do not select the media checkbox. All software is available for download, with only a subset of that software available through DVD shipments. Do not assign the media benefit unless the subscriber requires physical media. Instead, manage all of your benefits digitally by selecting the Subscriber Downloads checkbox. By selecting Subscriber Downloads, subscribers can log into the MSDN subscription portal and access all of their benefits. These include software downloads, Visual Studio Online, Windows Azure, developer accounts for Microsoft stores, support, training, and more. After you assign all the required component benefits to the subscriber, click Next. In the Assign Subscription area, type the subscriber's information in the text fields. A red asterisk indicates a required text field. You can also use the reference fields to keep track of additional information in your organization. For example, the subscriber's department, division, or employee number. Click Next. Review the subscriber's information and the details of the subscription. If needed, you can make edits by clicking the appropriate edit button. If all the information is correct, click Finish. A confirmation message appears, and the new subscriber appears in the top row of the results table. The new subscriber automatically receives a welcome email message that explains how to activate the subscription. To gain access to subscriber downloads and other subscription benefits, the subscriber must activate the subscription. You can save time by assigning subscriptions to multiple subscribers simultaneously. To begin the assignment process, click the Assign Multiple Subscriptions tab. Be sure that you are adding subscribers to the correct agreement by verifying the agreement information in the Agreement section. Below the Add Multiple Subscriptions heading, there are instructions. In Step 4, you must download a Microsoft Excel file and use the recommended version or higher of Excel to edit it. To ensure that you are using the most current file, check the last update, date for the file. Click Download. When the Excel file opens, click Save As and open the file. You may need to click the Enable Editing button. Then, go to the Instructions tab and follow the instructions you find there. Provide all the required information for each individual subscriber. Depending on the agreement type, you may also need to select a coverage end date. You can add a maximum of 5,000 subscribers per Excel file. However, Microsoft recommends that you add 500 subscribers per Excel file. Verify the information and correct any errors that appear in the error column, and then save the file. To upload the file, return to the Assign Multiple Subscriptions area and click Upload. Use the dialog box that appears to find your file, and then click Submit. Click Finish. Depending on the number of subscribers you uploaded, it may take some time for the request to process. Microsoft advises that you check back later to confirm that the assignment is complete. During the upload process, you may receive a message that errors have occurred. An error message appears next to each subscriber that could not be added. To edit a subscriber's information, click the last name of the subscriber. Make any corrections on the Add Multiple Subscribers error correction, Update Subscriber Information page, and click Next. Continue making any needed corrections, then click Next. After you review your changes and click Finish, the added successfully confirmation message appears. When the process is complete, you can view the newly assigned subscribers in the main MSDN Subscriptions Administration page. If a subscriber has left the company or changed responsibilities, it may be necessary to remove him. On the subscriber search page, locate the subscriber you want to remove from the list in the subscribers section or use the form in the search section. To use the search section, expand that section by clicking the arrow on the right. Find the subscriber by typing the subscriber's information in the search form's text fields. You can filter by various fields, including subscriber name, subscriber ID, country, and so on. Click Search. When the results appear, select the checkbox next to the subscriber's last name. If you want to remove multiple subscribers, you can select multiple checkboxes. Click the Remove Subscribers button. When the confirmation dialog appears, click OK. The MSDN Subscription Administration page updates with the subscriber no longer listed. the subscriber will no longer have access to the MSDN subscriptions portal. A subscriber's subscription level may change if a new license purchase or renewal results in a change to the level. You may also need to make benefits available, such as technical support, which were previously unavailable. Click the Subscriber Search tab. The Subscriber Search page appears with the search area hidden. To use the search section, expand the section by clicking the arrow on the right. Find the subscriber by typing the subscriber's information in the search form's text fields. You can filter by various fields, including subscriber name, subscriber ID, country, and so on. Click Search. When the results appear, click the subscriber's last name. On the subscriber details page, go to the section that contains the information you need to update. For example, to update the subscriber downloads details section, click that section's Add button. From the Select a Subscription Level drop-down menu, choose the new subscription level you want to assign to the subscriber. For example, Visual Studio Ultimate with MSDN. Click Save. You must now go back and remove the original subscription level from the subscriber. To do this, select the old subscription level and click Remove. When the confirmation dialog appears, click OK. The MSDN Subscription Administration Tool provides features that allow you to track media shipments and view a summary of the available and assigned subscriptions. To track media shipments, click the Shipment Search tab. To find a shipment, provide the required information in one or more of the fields on the page and click Search. In the Shipment List Search Results area, view the details of a shipment by clicking the shipment number. The Shipment Details page shows media details and shipping information by line item. To view a different shipment, click back to Shipment List. Now, to view summary information, return to the MSDN Subscription Administration page and click the Subscription Summary tab. The summary displays the total available subscriptions by subscription level. You can use the drop-down menus to filter the information. The summary shows how many subscriptions you have assigned and how many remain. Please note, a negative remaining balance indicates that you have assigned more subscriptions than you have purchased. You must make additional purchases to reconcile this per the terms of your agreement. To learn more about MSDN subscription management, go to the homepage of the VLSC site and download the administration guide. If needed, subscribers can seek assistance from MSDN customer service centers around the globe. Thank you for visiting the Microsoft Volume Licensing Service Center. We hope the MSDN subscriptions features assist you in managing MSDN subscriptions.